should be fine. I just wanted to let you know about that.
Okay, so as Jose mentioned before, this pathosystem is really complex. So there are many fungal species associated with the GDD symptoms. They have different biology and epidemiology, and of course, no curative measures are known for control of GDDs. So these diseases are best managed by an integrated strategy, including different tools, giving priority to non-chemical methods. So this strategy can be applied through the entire production chain for mother blocks to newly and mature vineyards. So in this presentation, I'm going to discuss the currently available strategies to reduce GDD infections based on published research, giving priority to experiments performed under nursery and field conditions. So proper pruning practice and protection, as well as cultural practices and sanitation, must be applied in mother blocks. Rootstock mother plants can be cultivated in several systems, so sprawl on the soil surface, sprawl on woven fabric, and with horizontal and vertical trellis system. So vines on a trellis system have some agronomical advantages, and it can also eliminate or reduce potential soil surface pathogen contamination. In contrast, these systems are much more labor intensive and expensive than vines sprawl on the ground. Regarding the irrigation, so different systems can be used to irrigate nursery mother blocks. Drip irrigation is strongly recommended since overwatering always favors most soil-borne pathogenic fungi. And in the case of overhead sprinkler irrigation, this system can trigger spore release of several GDD pathogens. Regarding the sanitation, removing and destroying all diseased wood from the vineyard still remains the best practice to reduce the number of new infections for all GDD pathogens affecting mother blocks and mature plants. Infected wood and pruning debris can be destroyed by composting, mulching, and incorporation into the soil of the vineyard or burning. So burning has several environmental disadvantages. Therefore, this practice is being replaced by other options such as composting and or mulching. So in France, researchers show composting of vine material along with sheep manure and garden residues for 6 months to successfully eliminate inoculum of GDD pathogens from grapevine wood tissue. At this point, I recommend reading this paper where we established a protocol for the management of grapevine rootstock mother vines to reduce GDD infections in cuttings. So we mentioned different options like training systems, irrigation, cultural practices and sanitation, and pruning wound protection. So winter pruning is the main port of entry of GDD pathogens in the vine. So pruning wound protection is essential to keep healthy plants. Nowadays, we have strong restrictions and difficulties on the use of chemicals to protect pruning wounds. So mastics and paints are by far the most reliable wound protectants, particularly when they are supplemented with fungicides, such as the benzimidazole carbamate mode of action group or the demethylation inhibitors. These fungicides can provide a physical barrier to stop the GDD pathogen spores from entering the vine, and they can also act on the pathogens if the physical barrier is compromised by subflow, drain, or cracking when drying. However, in general, the use of these fungicide groups is prohibited in most grape growing regions around the world. Recent research carried out in California and Spain demonstrated that the mixture piraclostrobin plus boscalid was very effective in protecting pruning wounds against GDD infection in commercial vineyards. This is a liquid formulation fungicide that can be applied with a sprayer. However, it cannot be used in an organic management. So an alternative that is gaining interest over the last years is the use of biological control agents. So most studies on the use of BCA have been focused in the application of trichoderma species under control conditions. So in general, biological control agents have shown variable results for preventing infection by GDD pathogens. So they show good performance under field condition in South Africa and Italy, but we had bad experience with the use of trichoderma to protect pruning wounds in commercial vineyards in Spain. Jose will probably talk later about his experience with the use of trichoderma in Canada. In the propagation processes, priority should be given to the application of biological and physical treatments due to the reduction in the availability of efficient chemicals in nurseries. So three important aspects to consider in this section. So nurseries provide nearly optimal environments for fungal development, wet and humid conditions in hydration tanks and cayusing, high root density within cayusing containers, and the field rooting stage. In general, close spacing of plants. This will enhance opportunities for pathogen spread and reproduction. Even with these favorable conditions for disease development risk, disease will not develop if the pathogens are not present. However, production practices in most nurseries provide many opportunities for fungal trunk pathogen introduction through a poor sanitation practices or through pruning wounds, the disbudding stage, or the dramatic action of putting together the scion and the rootstock in an omega grafting machine. Unfortunately, it's often difficult to detect trunk disease infected plants in the nursery. It's frequent to see in field nurseries this type of high quality planting material with no physical defects, no foliar symptoms, graft union healthy and strong, probably appropriate length and thickness of the rootstock with at least 3 to 4 buds and with healthy and evenly distributed roots. However, when we cut these plants at the base of the rootstock, we frequently appreciate these necrosis from which we frequently isolate fungal trunk pathogens. It is very common to see external asymptomatic plants. So these fungi can act as latent pathogens and may become pathogenic to the grapevine following biotic and or abiotic stress factors. So up to date, it's not possible to ensure that propagation material is free of GTD pathogens by non-destructive sampling. Given this scenario, the message is clear: start clean, keep it clean. So the recommendations are related to the use of pathogen-free planting material, to clean grafting machines frequently, maintain a high standard of general cleanliness in the nursery, particularly the grafting, cayusing, and cool rooms. Never reuse cayusing media, which is a potential source of the pathogen inoculum, and try to avoid soaking cuttings in water for long periods of time. This can create cross-contamination with other planting material. Although chemical control was effective in the past to control GTD pathogens in nurseries, only kinosol is currently authorized in Europe, in particular in Germany. And its efficacy is very low compared to, for example, carbendazime, cyproadenyl, and fludioxinil. One of the possible alternatives to the use of chemical control in nurseries is the application of biological control agents. Recently, researchers in Italy and Spain demonstrated that the application of Trichoderma atrovirida, the strain SC1, at the hydration stage effectively reduced infection by Petri disease pathogens in Italian and Spanish nurseries and Botryosphaeriasis species in Spanish nurseries. So no significant effect was observed against blackfoot disease severity. Another option, so treating propagation material with hot water could be one of the most effective methods to reduce fungal infection. However, some anecdotal reports of high losses have been published, especially when long duration treatments are applied to cuttings. It's important to consider that some Vitis vinifera varieties are more sensitive to hot water treatment than others. For example, in this study carried out in Australia, Pinot Noir was highly sensitive to the treatment and Cabernet Sauvignon was the least sensitive among several cultivars. So it's also important to consider that the tolerance of plants to hot water treatment is affected by the climate in which the cuttings are grown. For example, in New Zealand, they cannot treat more than 50 degrees because 50 degrees causes mortality of cuttings, On the other hand, studies conducted in Spain have shown that 53 degrees significantly improves efficacy against trunk disease pathogens without any effect on grapevine cuttings. So in general, New Zealand has a cooler climate than Spain. And finally, hot water treatment is not completely effective in eliminating fungal trunk disease pathogen growth. In this study, we examined fungal communities after hot water treatment using high throughput amplicon sequencing based on total RNA, and demonstrated that these treatments reduced the infection caused by fungal trunk disease pathogens, but was not completely effective in eliminating their growth. So we got some colonies, some percentage of abundances of these pathogens at 53 degrees. In the nursery field, I think it's important to highlight alternative strategies to chemical control, and a promising practice is the biofumigation. After cayusing, here in the process, after cayusing, vines are transported and planted in an open root field nursery. So the rooting nursery soil is a critical propagation stage where fungal trunk pathogens, mainly blackfoot fungi, can infect planting material in grapevine. Here you can see the disease cycle of blackfoot. Blackfoot pathogens persist in soil as mycelium in rotten root fragments or as resting spores called chlamydospores that can survive for several years. Blackfoot pathogens can also infect alternative hosts such as weeds or cereals, which makes the implementation of crop rotation in nurseries really difficult. In Portugal and South Africa, researchers demonstrated an increase of blackfoot disease incidence in a crop rotation cycle. In addition, blackfoot disease fungi have been detected directly from soil during rotation systems with wheat and barley in Portugal and Spain. Biofumigation could be a sustainable alternative to the use of chemicals. Biofumigation with Indian mustard seed meal in New Zealand and with white mustard in Spain and Canada reduce blackfoot disease incidence and fungal inoculum in soil. In newly established vineyards, it's important to select apparently healthy planting material and also carry out an adequate site preparation and vine management. So in this section, I will also talk about the current status of biological control as a preventive strategy before planting. Here's some recommendations for growers to select grafted plants. Just to highlight that grafted plants should have at least 3 healthy, undamaged, and evenly spaced roots, as you can see in this photo. Grafts should be fully healed, not overgrown, and not able to be broken by moderate pressure applied by the thumb, as you can see here in these photos. As I suggested before, a mustard seed meal can be incorporated into the soil, or a rotation crop of mustard can be grown until flowering and then incorporated before planting. In addition, compacted soil layers should be broken up before planting and vines should be well placed in large planting holes. In many instances, blackfoot disease can be found in association with a condition known as J-rooting. So this condition is the result of poor planting of the vines in which roots are oriented upward. Here we can see an infected vine that developed a second layer of roots due to blackfoot disease in order to compensate for the loss of functional roots farther below. Regarding the pre-planting strategies, recent research carried out under field conditions investigated the efficacy of several biological control agents to prevent infections by blackfoot and Petri disease pathogens. In South Africa, trichoderma species were not sufficient to prevent infections by blackfoot disease pathogens, but a certain degree of protection was obtained in the basal ends. In Spain, we recently performed an experiment to evaluate the preventive effect of two potential biological control agents, that is Streptomyces sp and the oomycete Pidium oligandrum, and 3 BCA commercial products containing Trichoderma troveride, Trichoderma coningi, and a mixture of bacteria, so Pseudomonas fluorescens plus Bacillus atrophaeus. So the conclusion of this study was that one biological control agent alone was not completely effective in reducing GTD incidence and severity. So the combination of the disease suppressive activity of 2 or more beneficial microbes is required to prevent fungal infection. So we have now to consider the viability of this action and if it's viable or not for the grower to combine several biological control agents. Another interesting option would be the application of arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi as a preplanting strategy. Recent research carried out by the group of Miranda Hart in collaboration with other researchers, mostly in Canada, demonstrated basically that colonization by arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi did not suppress black foot pathogens, but instead increased the abundance of them. And the commercial arbuscular mycorrhizal fungal inoculant failed to establish in a vineyard despite priority advantage. So I think more research is needed to assess the efficacy of these products against TDD pathogens. Regarding the management of young vines, adequate vine and root development should be allowed to occur prior to placing a heavy fruit load on vines in the early production years in order to avoid this type of stress. So this is the ideal situation, no yield during the first 3 years and increasing the yield little by little until full production the year 8 or 10 after planting, depending on the rootstock and cultivar combination. So we should avoid that. This is the second year after planting, second harvest in central Spain, in Castilla-La Mancha. And here the ideal situation, this is the third summer. So we have the plant ready to train and we have to avoid this situation. At this point in this review by Jose and collaborators, you can find all the information related to stress factors and disease development. So you can check this, this paper. I would like to recommend reading these other papers. The first one by Helen Waite and collaborators in Australia about grapevine propagation principles and methods for the production of high quality grapevine planting material. And the second one, a review we published in Plant Disease 3 years ago about the management of grapevine thrush diseases in nurseries, young and mature vineyards. To conclude my presentation, just to say that the spread of fungal trunk pathogens via infected nursery material is an established problem that cannot be solved quickly. So nurseries must undertake substantial efforts to improve sanitation. And now we observe that tree crop nurseries are also struggling to meet demands for plant material, as in the case of grapevine many years ago. So we have many reports of trunk disease pathogens in other crops, in nurseries, almond and forest nurseries in Spain, blueberry nurseries in New Zealand, and olive nurseries in South Africa. So a general question, can we really produce disease-free plant material even when following clean production best management practices? As a future direction, so the development of a clean plant certification programs have several challenges. As we mentioned before, a broad range of taxonomically unrelated pathogens are included in this pathosystem. So the plant nursery conditions and practices favor fungal infection, and the detection and identification requires destructive sampling. So a fast and reliable method for screening large number of plants for fungal trunk pathogens infections is needed. So Jose developed a DNA macroarray some time ago. This can be a good option. And for viruses, so they use next generation sequencing approaches from asymptomatic tissues to screen large number of plants. So it can be adopted to fungal trunk pathogens or grapevine. And we also need to assess the impact of global trade and the implication of trunk disease infection in other tree crop nurseries. So finally, I would like to acknowledge the Canadian Grapevine Certification Network for inviting me to give this seminar. So hope you enjoy the seminar and thanks for listening.